Hi, I'm Chip Ritter, and in this video, I'm going to talk about understanding triplets. Everything I just played had something to do with triplets. Triplets permeate almost all forms of music, especially the cool drum parts like licks and fills that go like this. All of that stuff requires a knowledge of triplets. So, let's go ahead and understand what a triplet is. A triplet is three things, three notes. One, two, three. Or one, two, three, depending on how you look at it. Count to three over and over and over, and you got triplets. It's like 3-4 time. If you don't understand 3-4 time, you're in trouble. So you gotta go back there, right? To start understanding triplets, let's play some 3-4 time. Count to three over and over. Hit the bass drum on one, and the snare drum on three. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. All right, anyway. So 3-4 time, practice 3-4 time, and then you understand it's gonna go over and over and over and over identically. It's just gonna repeat in a steady stream of the same three sounding notes over and over, right? The thing that makes them triplets is the context in which we're playing them, because we're starting three over and over, and every time we start that three, we're gonna count another number like this. One, two, three, four, two, three. Then we just put it in 4-4 time. So I'm gonna hit my snare drum, and I'm gonna hit my bass drum on every one when I count to three over and over, which will put triplets in 4-4 time. One, two, three, 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 four. Practice that with your left hand, because when you're alternating, that's gonna come up, right? A lot of people have trouble doing that because of the left when they start out drumming, and they start to try to go like this. But they've never done this before. So my recommendation, if you're new to triplets and you haven't a deep understanding of triplets yet, practice this a lot first. With your left hand, or your opposite hand, or your weaker hand, or your hand that just doesn't get enough love. After you practice that a while, then start alternating and try this. Those could be considered whatever we're looking at. It depends on the context of the music. But if you're thinking about eighth note triplets, then yeah, those are eighth notes. One, two, three, four. If I did 16th note triplets, it would be like this. One and two and three and four and. Same thing if I did like 32nd note triplets, it'd be. Right? Ad infinitum, okay? So practice all of them. And then you could do things like single stroke fours, which is your second rudiment of all time, and I know you love your rudiments. To put that in context, play a beat and do four single stroke fours, and you're on your way into the world of triplets. I hope this lesson helped you understand triplets better. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks for watching. Keep time, have fun, and be yourself.